Hogan and Bret Hart. What do we got here? What's
the man?
Yeah, it's the man. And it's unexpectedly the man. He's not even in his wrestling gear. And Goldberg, surrounded by policemen, by WCW security, obviously making his way towards the ring area.
Well, just by his facial expression, he's got something on his mind.
The fans here in the arena watching the Jumbotron, as you see Prince Iaukea, who was scheduled to wrestle Jerry Flynn, standing with his arms out to his side as if to say, what is going on here? Well, I'll tell you what's going on here. Anything that Goldberg wants is going on here. Here he comes!
What is on his mind?
It's a much different entrance we've seen as he's with the pyro and the smoke and going to the ring. Goldberg, obviously, something to say because he has not come to the ring apparently here to wrestle. As you look at the fans.
I don't think Goldberg needs boots and trunks.
Jerry Flynn, I truly apologize for this. I know you got a match, but I got something very important to say. So if you just give me a second, please.
You're not getting back up, buddy.
Give him 5 seconds if he wants.
Jimmy Hart, very smart here.
You know what, people? I've always been told that good things are worth waiting for. But I've run out of patience. Every week, I've been watching you, Sid.
Oh my goodness.
I've been watching you come out here and wreak havoc, yes. And I will admit that I admire your skill. I admire your size. I admire your strength. But one thing I will not stand for is your mouth. And tonight, I put a stop to it. You know, I worked hard at my record. I came out here and destroyed everybody, one after one. But unlike me, Sid, you cheat. You come from behind. You come in unscheduled matches, and you stick your nose into people's business. I don't admire that, Sid. So, tonight, I draw the line. Tonight, I stomp a hole in your ass. So tonight, you show these people, and more importantly, you show me that you got a backbone. You come out from the back, and you show me, Sid, one-on-one, who the man is.
Sid Vicious, come on down.
Because not only do I know who it is, these people know who it is. And it ain't you. So quit singing it and start bringing it. Because you're next. And I got all the time in the world. So come on, Sid. I'm waiting.
Yeah. Where talk is cheap.
Come on, big man.
And the deal is...
See what you got.
It doesn't happen. That's why I say it's ready to happen, see? Because it's my show. It's my belt.
And I guess I see how it's going to be.
I'm making decisions around here.
Way to show the people, Sid. If it ain't tonight, could be tomorrow. You never know, because your ass is next.
He has drawn the line. It's way overdue.
Now we know who's next.
Oh, Jerry, what's Jerry Flynn trying to accomplish here?
Oh! He's trying to get himself murdered.
So we're in for a spirited jackhammer, are we, Bray?
Oh, we certainly are. Look at this. Watch this. There is the man. He's watching.
Didn't even need a penny. And I really think that Sid got the belt, got the duffel bag that he may have been leaving this arena. One thing we know, he's not coming out here. And who can blame him?
I'll tell you, he's ready. He is ready as he'll ever be.
And the fans